Today's demanding academic research needs sophisticated computing power. What if there was a way to put spare computing power at a university to good use by making it available to others? If we can pool this computing power together, we will be able to speed up research work. That's exactly what the European grid infrastructure does. With the grid, this network of computer servers at universities across Europe supports a wide range of cutting-edge research. Welcome to Stories from the Grid. In this episode, the Epigonion. This Greek string instrument hasn't been heard for centuries. Ancient information of the Epigonion has been combined with the power of the grid to recreate its sound. Now it can be played once again in this orchestra, using just a keyboard and a laptop. Got a keyboard of your own? Then you might just as well download the sounds of the Epigonion and play it yourself. This all started with one man who believes that harmony in nature and in physics are not that far apart.
I'm a scientist, a researcher and the music composer. The Epigonion is an extremely interesting instrument. So it is dated fifth or sixth century before Christ. It has 48 strings. The Epigonion, if you like, is the first instrument in history that allowed the players to play harmonies together, so to pluck more than one string at the same time. Creating sound libraries and making them available for everybody, we thought it was much more attractive than just having a beautifully crafted, wooden-made sample of the Epigonion to be put in a museum and only just a few lucky people could touch it.
But how do you digitally recreate the sound of an instrument that hasn't been around for thousands of years?
We have quite a lot of description about the history of this instrument. We analyze pictures from pottery, frescoes, from Greek vases. This is the kind of information we normally work with.
All this information was then combined in reconstruction software to calculate what the Epigonion sounded like. This technique is called physical modeling.
The reconstruction of each strings of the Epigonion can be considered as a separate problem. So you have 48 strings, for example. You can have 48 different reconstruction jobs that you can run on the grid. On a standard laptop or a standard computer, reconstructing all the sounds that we need to play an Epigonion would take something like a month worth of computation or calculation. On the grid, it just takes 2 to 4 hours. The results are coming back from the grid, typically as a zip file or as a file containing 48 audio files. Each of them is the reproduction of the sound of that particular string. In this way, any musician can play the Epigonion just using a keyboard.
Once calculated, the sounds of the Epigonion could be used for a number of interesting musical experiments. One of them is the Lost Sounds Orchestra, which features reconstructed instruments like the Epigonion.
We are recording a series of pieces for a CD, for example, with real musicians and an Epigonion. And this is just a way to show people that we can actually use the Epigonion as a modern instrument, as a guitar or as any other instrument.
So, to wrap it all up, to recreate the sound of the Greek Epigonion, information from ancient sources has been collected to find out what the instrument looked like, what materials it was made of, how the strings were constructed, and how it was played. This knowledge was combined with a technique called physical modeling. Calculations were then needed to find out how all the properties would work together to create the sound for each of the 48 strings. For each string, these calculations were sent to the grid. The results that came back were used to create a sound library. So musicians anywhere can now freely play the Epigonion. Now we know how the grid has helped to find out what an Epigonion sounds like, what more could be possible in the future?
I work for Dante, the organization building and operating GEANT, the European Backbone for Research and Education. Thanks to this project and thanks to the role of advanced networking and grid computing, we expect that musicians can eventually be able to play together with really low latency and probably having a concert or a jam session sitting in their homes or in their institutions that can be thousands of kilometers away.
The vast computing power of the grid has turned out to be an excellent tool for musical science. Want to see how the grid is useful in other fields of research? Then join us next time for another episode of Stories. stories from the grid.